Next, you're going to just stitch the tail and the bit to leave an opening to stuff later. So as you can see on this, and I'll show you on the pattern as well, you have this little swoop where the back is, and then you have the little tail here. So what you're going to do, where that little tail is, right here on the pattern, you're going to stitch straight from there to the bottom. Then I wouldn't trim it because you're going to go ahead and attach the bottom piece, which is this one, and you're going to cut one of these out, same as the body, just one. Unless you put it on the fold and then this, it's still cutting one, but yeah, going back to this. This is only one. So once again, I'm going to get my handy dandy pinning out so I can show you guys this better. And pinning it like so. And depending on how you sew, you may not need the pins, you may need the pins. I have sewn all these, the ones I did before now, without pins, but I'm doing it with pins so that I can show you. So. And I made mine just obviously a little too big for the bottom, so I'm just going to go and see how close I can get it together, like so, and then I'm just going to fold the piece over. So, then you got the base all pinned on. So, then you're going to go from where you left off with the tail and straight into the bottom piece. Making sure you're on the side that's going to be on the inside. These should be on this side as well. And if you notice I'm kind of backstitching every so many times, it's just because I'm afraid I might have too big of spacing. You don't have to do that, necessarily. I'm just doing it to make sure I've locked it in place and I know it's not going to come apart. Especially, it depends on what you're using. If you're using like a polar fleece or if you're using something that's thinner weight fabric, it will be easier to know how much you need to do for stitching. Otherwise you're just going to do a basic straight stitch on the side. And then you'll go in a complete circle all the way around on the edge. About half, maybe a centimeter, half a centimeter. I don't know. Something like that. I'm giving great help, ain't I? And then go back to the tail and just tie off your string, like so. Ta-da. Go around, make sure you got all your pins out. I got it all except for that one. And then, now that you got the bottom on, we get to add our cute little head. So, this is your front, where all your little your three little darts are. Then you're going to stick his little chin on the middle dart. And we're going to get our handy dandy pins out again and go pin run here and then turn and go around the edges and pin as you go. All the way around. Like so. And yes, I put that down. You guys can see this. And then starting where I did not pin, I'm gonna go over here and then go all the way around. Ow. Without trying to stick myself in the finger. Because needles are sharp, people, especially when you're sewing with them. Or if you're me, you just accidentally pin yourself and then realize it after the fact. Back around. Just keep stitching in the same spot until you make sure you've got a good old knot there that you know is not going to come undone. Probably would have helped if I didn't make my string like extremely long. And cut your string. Take your friendly pins out, put them back in the pin cushion because that's where they go. Not on the floor, not on the couch, not under the bed. Back in the pin cushion where they belong. There's a bad joke there. Not really a bad joke, just not very thought out one. Now, you have your little flippers that you're gonna stitch on. And then stitching on his feet is the last thing you gotta do. And with those, where that third little knot is where I kind of estimated where they should go. Kind of center it on there. And then just stitch straight across first. Straight across right here. And then, as you can see, you can kind of have that little gap here on the shoulder. You're just going to want to go ahead and blanket stitch, or I guess you could call it a whip stitch, I'm not really sure. I'm not good with technical terms. Just watch what I'm doing and hopefully you'll know what I'm talking about. Sewed my scissors. Not my intention. Then you get back right where you started. Then make a knot, pull it tight, and scissors. Do-do-do. Go ahead and do it on the other side. And so that you don't have to hold it on with your finger, you could also put a pin in it. That would also save you some strain on your hands. I just like making my life complicated. So. Okay. And stitching across again. Making the knot. Like so. Then stitching the crust. Make another knot on the other side, like so. And then again, going back across with your little stitching, like so. And then make a little knot and cut it with the scissors. Now you got his little wingies on. And then he's stuffing. Now you're gonna put his little feet on. Which the pattern shows the feet as 3D. I'm just doing it easy way and making it single BBs. And same with the beak, single little beak. I'm going to get my fancy thread out. Making fun of my sewing supplies. All my stuff I get from like thrift stores and cheaping out by getting it for 50 cents. And the air just kicked on. All this stuff that none of you really need to know. But hey, you learned something, didn't you? Flip them over and kind of stretch them out a little. And I'm kind of going to just position these whatever way I feel works. And we're gonna put a pin in his foot, like so. In the penguin foot. Make sure you're putting it in the penguin's foot. Not anywhere else, because if you put it in your own foot, that will hurt. Okay, that was bad. Trying to make a joke, didn't work. I should learn by now. I don't do comedy. I do weirdness. And I'm just stitching a big circle around the main portion of his foot, leaving his toes sticking out from underneath of him. Not pulling it too tight, because otherwise you'll have a big old knot. Pull the needle out. And come back around. Pull it again. Stretch it out so you don't get a mess. And then, so I don't have to tie a knot yet, I'm going to go underneath all that and then push it through to where the other foot will be. So you just want to go straight from this foot to this foot. And then right around the little foot. Down through here so you can hide your knot underneath your foot. Like so. Pull it tight. Trim your thread. Trim this thread here. And then you got your penguin pretty much ready, and all you just gotta do is get stuffed. But because he's for something I need for later on, I'm going to put him aside just like this and he'll be stuffed by somebody else later on in his lifetime. So, when you're done and he gets stuffed, I'm just going to show you this. You don't have much to do afterwards except for stitch his back up because you got a hole still here. After you put the stuffing in, you'll stitch that up. And then, optional, just a simple, I'm just going to show you even though he's already got it on this butt, on his tail here. All I did was go straight through like this. And then straight down and oops, throw them across the room. No, not literally. Straight up again, straight down again. A couple times to get that good and tight, and then go under like so and do a quick slip knot. Like that. And then he'll have this cute little tail. And this guy doesn't have any feet because I didn't put feet on him. So he's a sad penguin. So, sticking them over there. And I'll bring you guys back up. So, yeah, that's pretty much it. If you guys have any questions or comments, put them down below and I'll get back to you. Once again, I'm sorry I've been gone. I just started a job this, like, the last 3 months, a new job. So, yeah, I'm a little chaotic, so, right now. Schedule hopefully will get back to normal every other week like it was on Thursdays, hopefully. Hopefully. We'll see. We got at the end of this month we got Con coming up, so everybody's excited about Con. See you guys then. If not sooner. But all right. I'm Calliope and I'm signing out.